I'm Christelle from Diabetes Strong. I love to exercise, but it can be really, really complicated when living with insulin-dependent diabetes. And no one told me up front, you know, how to not go low during exercise. That ultimately led me to start Diabetes Strong, but it's also really frustrating because we know how to significantly reduce the risk of low blood sugars during exercise. There are guidelines available. And if you struggle with low blood sugars during exercise, it's most likely because no one has ever sat down and just explained it to you. Low blood sugars are the worst, and there's probably nothing more irritating or frustrating when you have to stop mid-workout, maybe even before you're even getting started, to drink juice or eat. But it doesn't have to be that way. Low blood sugars and exercise does not have to go hand in hand, and you don't have to carb up to go for a walk around the block. There are two levers we can pull when it comes to reducing the risk of low blood sugars during and after exercise. And I say reduce because this is diabetes, we'll never be able to completely eliminate the risk of low blood sugars. The two levers are you can either eat more or you can manipulate your insulin levels or your IOB, so your active insulin on board. Because in reality, the only reason why you go low during exercise is if you have too much IOB. So before we start talking about strategies for reducing lows during exercise by manipulating insulin or food, let's just talk about why you generally go low during exercise. The type of exercise that most often make blood sugars drop is called aerobic exercise. So you can see the heart rate here. This is the heart rate profile of aerobic exercise. It's that type of exercise where heart rate comes up and it stays up while you're doing the activity, and once you're done, the heart rate comes down again. So examples of that would be brisk walking, jogging, biking, swimming, or everyday activities such as going to Target, going to the mall, vacuuming, cleaning, gardening, walking your dog around the block. Generally, as your heart rate comes up, your blood sugars will start to drop. For most people, they'll start to drop in about 10-15 minutes, but it's very individual. But for most people, once the activity is done and the heart rate is back into normal level, blood sugars will stop dropping or maybe even start to climb up a little bit. January 2017, we finally got good guidelines for how to adjust food and insulin for exercise. So it was published in The Lancet, and I can leave a link to it down below if you're interested. It was about type 1 diabetes and exercise. I think it's applicable to anyone who injects insulin multiple times a day, so let's not get too caught up in labels here. Let's look at it. Every time I show these guidelines, this is the first one I show. This is directly from the publication. This is, don't read this, this is gonna be too much. Let me show you instead this. This is a summary of those guidelines that we just looked at. This is for exercise longer than 30 minutes. Again, it was published in The Lancet in 2017. What you need to focus on are two different things. First, are you fasting or are you not fasting? Fasting means that you haven't injected any insulin or eaten within the last 4 hours. For most people, that would be when we get up in the morning. There's two levers again, as I mentioned. There's the basal reduction or the carbs. There are different strategies depending on whether or not you're on a pump or you are on MDI, multiple daily injections, basically if you use pen or syringes. For pump, if you use a pump, it is recommended that you reduce your basal, so your background insulin, with 50 to 80% up to 90 minutes before you start your exercise. The 90 minutes is because insulin doesn't start to work right away. It takes a little while. So insulin, most insulin, like your Humalog and your Novolog, starts, it doesn't enter the bloodstream until 10 to 15 minutes after it's injected. It doesn't peak until 90 minutes or for an hour to 90 minutes in, okay? Another alternative is to completely suspend all insulin delivery for up to 60 minutes. Up to 60 minutes is because we don't want you to be completely without any insulin that can lead to DKA, even with good blood sugars. So that's a reason for the 60 minutes. Alternatively is if you haven't suspended, you want to go for your workout and you suspect that you might go low, is to eat more carbohydrates. If on MDI, multiple daily injections, there is the possibility of reducing your basal insulin with up to 20%. What they say that's predominant for prolonged exercise, meaning that if you go for like a half marathon or Ironman or something a little more aggressive. If you do find that you go low fasting in the morning, they recommend eating up to 20 to 30 grams of carbs an hour. Most people do not go low in the morning on MDI simply because long-acting insulin does not get impacted as aggressively by exercise as rapid-acting insulin does. Now we're done with our workout. We're still on the left-hand side under fasting. Well, if you're going to eat within an hour and a half after exercise in 90 minutes, it's recommended that you reduce your bolus, meaning your mealtime insulin, by up to 50%. Because your insulin sensitivity, how effective your body is at utilizing the insulin you inject, is going to be heightened post-activity. There's also a recommendation of an overnight basal reduction of up to 20%. So if you tend to see low blood sugars after a day of exercising, you could consider reducing your insulin. That was the fasting side of things. Let's look at the non-fasting, or you know, those situations where you're exercising after breakfast, you're exercising afternoon or evening. So you've eaten within the last 4 hours. Here we go. Here is the suggestion is, if you're not fasting, reduce your bolus or your mealtime insulin by 25 to 75%. That's a huge range. It's huge because how much you need to reduce it is gonna be very dependent on you and your physiology. So we'll talk a little bit more about how you find out how much to reduce it in a second. Alternatively, if you're in a situation where the insulin is injected, once it's in the body, it's in the body, you can't really do anything about that, would be to eat 0.5 to 1 grams of carbs per kilogram that you weigh. Okay, so that's a little bit more. I think most people just grab 15 to 20 grams of carbs, but if you want to be really technical about it, this is the formula for that. Then there's how to adjust your basal insulin. So the recommendation is to do exactly the same as if you were fasting. So there you just follow the same guidelines, which is a pump basal reduction of 50 to 80% or suspension. And if MDI, potentially do a basal reduction. So to summarize, in order to reduce the risk of low blood sugars during exercise, you need to adjust your insulin or you need to eat more. So adjusting your insulin is focusing on your active insulin on board, or your IOB, both from your basal, so your background insulin, as well as all the boluses you take being for your meals and for corrections. Finding the right amount of IOB should be done for a given activity as well as for time of day. So for example, most of us are more insulin sensitive in the afternoon, so you'll need a different formula or a different adjustment for afternoons. It can be really hard to learn your IOB needs or finding your formula if you don't have a structured approach. I recommend writing things down and then start to look for trends. I will link to my free exercise sheet below. It's a tracking sheet that I recommend that you use. It's the one I use with all my clients. If you use that consistently, I promise you, you will start to see trends. You'll start to see your formula. You'll be able to adjust your insulin and significantly reduce the amount of lows that you have when you exercise. I really believe that there's nothing we can't do with diabetes. It does require that we have the right mindset. That's why you're here. We have the right tools and the right knowledge. And the knowledge is exactly what we've been working on today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a like, give me a follow. Thank you so much.